This animation illustrates the strategy of frequency encoding. The top left and right panels show an array of 7x7 voxels in the rotating and laboratory frames, respectively, with each arrow representing the net transverse magnetization vector of all the dipoles within the voxel. The bottom panel shows a set of timelines. The top shows the RF power that causes the initial 90-degree spin flip. The second line shows application of an externally impressed gradient along the x-axis. The third timeline is new and indicates when the detected signal is actually acquired for image processing. And the bottom timeline again shows the detected total signal. Application of the gradient causes a slightly larger Z magnetic field towards the right and a slightly smaller Z magnetic field towards the left. This causes a slight adjustment in precessional frequency, such that spins process with a higher frequency towards the right side and a lower frequency towards the left side. The amount of adjusted frequency change is a known quantity with two important features. 1. All spins along a given column have the same frequency. And 2. Each column has a different and unique frequency, the variation of which depends upon the magnitude and duration of the impressed gradient. Then, in effect, the x-axis location of each spin becomes encoded by its new adjusted frequency. That is, all spins along a column are frequency encoded. Notice that this encoding is provided only as long as the gradient is on. As such, signal acquisition must occur during this time. This is in contradiction to phase encoding, the next animation for which the gradient is turned off before signal acquisition.